The Solicitor General has just released his advice to government about former Prime Minister Scott Morrison secretly appointing himself to 5 portfolios. Since breaking, this scandal has gathered momentum and created global headlines. Here's everything you need to know about Morrison's secret ministerial portfolios and the outcome of the Solicitor General's report. Read more: Morrison secret ministry appointment valid but undermined principles of responsible government. What's the story here? During the coronavirus pandemic, while Hughes was prime minister, Morrison was secretly sworn in as minister of 5 portfolios. At least 3 ministers had no knowledge it had even happened. 5 portfolios? I thought there were 3. When the story first broke, there were 3: Department of Health, Department of Finance and Department of Industry, Science, Energy, and Resources. But it's 5? Correct. Morrison was also sworn in to take control of Home Affairs and the Treasury. When did this all happen? Morrison was secretly sworn into 5 appointments on 4 days, between March 2020, May 2021. March 14, 2020, Department of Health 30 March 2020, Department of Finance 15 April 2021, Department of Industry, Science, Energy and Resources 6 May 2021, Department of Home Affairs 6 May 2021, Department of Treasury. Read more: the glaring questions Morrison still needs to answer about secret ministries. Where did the story come from? The secret swearing-in revelations are contained in Plagued, a new book which covers Morrison's prime ministership. Was it illegal? No. Under Australian law, the Governor-General can swear a Prime Minister into a portfolio without anybody else knowing. Releasing the Solicitor General's advice, Albanese said Morrison was within his legal boundaries by appointing himself to various ministerial portfolios. But Albanese said the report is a very clear critique of the Morrison government. The Solicitor General said Morrison's secret acts were inconsistent with how a responsible government should function. Even the ministers didn't know? When Morrison took control of finance, then Minister Matthias Cormann did not know. Karen Andrews, then Home Affairs Minister, also had no idea Morrison had joined control. She has urged Morrison to resign. Treasurer Josh Frydenberg did not know. Health Minister Greg Hunt was apparently aware. Read more: Scott Morrison defiant after taking on secret portfolios. Who were the ministers in charge at the time? Andrews was Home Affairs Minister, Hunt the Health Minister, Frydenberg served as Treasurer, and Keith Pitt the Minister for Industry, Science, Energy, and Resources. Cormann served as Minister for Finance for 8 months, with Morrison also sworn into the role. But after Cormann left Parliament, Simon Birmingham took over the role. Morrison dismissed suggestions he didn't have the courage to tell his frontbench colleagues he had secretly taken their jobs. Why did Morrison do this? Morrison said he took on the extra responsibilities because of the extraordinary circumstances of the pandemic. He rejected suggestions his invocation of emergency powers was a dictatorial move. I did what I thought was necessary in the national interest to ensure the government continued to perform well, he said. Will he resign? No. Morrison has refused to resign as the member for Cook and did not concede he had done anything wrong. On releasing the Solicitor General's report, Albanese held back from calling for Morrison to resign. That was a matter for Morrison and the Liberals, Albanese said. Morrison's behavior was extraordinary, and undermined our parliamentary democracy, and he does need to be held accountable. What about the ethics of it? Becoming Minister of Health at the start of the pandemic seemed reasonable, according to Nine's political editor Chris Ullman. Morrison's actions arose from that law which, under the Biosecurity Act, would have given Health Minister Hunt power over the country, Ullman said. However, Ullman said Morrison should have been transparent about this. Read more: why Aussies would survive longest in war. Did Morrison use ministerial powers? Just once, Morrison said. What was his one-off intervention? It was linked to a gas project off the coast of NSW which Morrison was against because it potentially threatened Liberal seats during the ill-fated 2022 federal election. I made a decision in industry for national interests, is all Morrison has said for now. The Solicitor General said Morrison was validly appointed to the portfolio. Could this happen again? Yes, but not in secret. Albanese is considering legislative changes because there needs to be absolute confidence in our political system. All ministerial appointments will be published from now on, he said. And so what happens now? Albanese is initiating a broader non-political inquiry headed by a preeminent figure which will look into Morrison's appointment to multiple ministries. Separately, at an appropriate time, there may be an inquiry into the government's response to the COVID-19 pandemic.